Won't you sing me the Red River Valley? It brings back memories.
We had only been dating a few months, and I had gotten a phone call where these guys wanted a folk singer on a boat ride. It was 1976. They were going to be golfing all day, enjoying Holland. And I didn't hear anything about any girlfriends or wives or anything coming along, and I felt a little weird about it. So I said, "Can I bring my boyfriend?" "Oh yeah, bring your boyfriend, that'd be great." So they were going to be golfing all day, then they were going to get on a boat in Holland, take it down to Saugatuck, and then back to Holland, and have dinner at Point West. So I said, "Sure, sounds great." So we did that. We got on the boat, and all I can remember is it must have been a very calm day because Max never turned green, so it had to have been calm. He's not real good with waves. Well, neither am I, so.
But don't make that motion. It bothers me.
But they were putting the tables together for our dinner, and it was going to take them a little while. It was a large group, and so they were having yet another happy hour, I guess you could call it a happier hour, out on the lawn, and I was still singing a few tunes. And a fellow walked up to me, and he was in perfect 70s golf garb. He had the lemon chiffon yellow slacks and the white shoes and the white belt and the purple Madras sport coat. I really like the coat. And he walked up, and he asked me for a song. And I was amazed and stunned and impressed by his accent. And so I didn't answer him right away, because I couldn't quite place the accent. And he figured that I needed more information. So he told me he had been, as a young man, with the Italian resistance during World War II. And that there was a point in time where he and his other resistance mates had been working with some soldiers that had been from different countries. And at night, they would dig their foxholes in, and they'd go back by nationality. And the Americans were all the way in the back. And there were, when it got quiet at night, he said you could hear this music. And he realized that one of the Americans was carrying a guitar through all this madness. And this was a song that he remembered from that guy playing. And so that was the inspiration for this song. I was singing in a bar. He put money in my jar. Asked if I could play for him a love song. Was one he had in mind of a cowboy and his bride that he'd heard the first time on the wind. Won't you sing me the Red River Valley? It brings back a time that has gone by. Won't you sing it so sweetly, just as I remember lying on the ground near my home. In a place far away, long ago, yes, we were bold and young, made a difference. There was blood, there was fear. Late at night, there were tears and a voice that could be heard in the distance. Won't you sing me? Red River Valley. you sing it so sweetly, just as I remember. So for a moment, friends long gone will seem alive. From this valley they say you are going. I will much. And as Paul Harvey would say, now the rest of the story. This summer we did that song at the farmer's market in Grand Haven, and a lady walked up to me and said, I want you to meet my sister. I brought her so she could hear your Red River Valley song, because the first time I heard it, she said, all the little hairs stood up on my arms, and I was just so blown away, because that's the story of my Uncle Johnny. And I'm going, what? How could that be? I mean, I wrote this song, you know. And she told me that her Uncle Johnny had carried a guitar and a mandolin through Italy in World War II. And he was killed in 1944. And she sent me photographs of Uncle Johnny in Italy with his guitar and this old Italian lady in the background. Won't you sing me the Red River? It brings back memories of a time that